Hello again from ChemHelp ASAP. In this video, we're going to talk about the relationship between effective nuclear charge and electronegativity in a vertical sense on the periodic table. So on the screen, we have a small portion of a periodic table, groups 1 and 7 and 8. Group 2 is sort of absent in this picture. And we've also listed the electronegativity of the elements. And we're going to focus on group 7. Right here. So electronegativity of fluorine, and that includes all of our halogens. So the electronegativity of fluorine is 4.0, chlorine is 3.2, bromine is 3.0, and iodine is 2.7. Now, one thing we've said is that effective nuclear charge influences our electronegativity. But since these are all group 7 elements, that means that they have 7 valence electrons, and they have an effective nuclear charge of 7. So within this column of the periodic table, this group, the effective nuclear charge is constant, and yet electronegativity is dropping by quite a bit. So we need to bring in another factor to explain this change in electronegativity. And to do that, we're going to talk about the van der Waals radius. Now the van der Waals radius, we're going to list these values in angstroms, and an angstrom is 10 to the minus 10th meters. So let's look at these values. The van der Waals radius for fluorine is about 1.47 angstroms. Chlorine is 1.75. Bromine is 1.85. And iodine comes in at 1.98. So as we can see, these atoms are getting larger as we go down the periodic table and we add more and more shells of electrons to the element. So if we think about this, why would the electronegativity decrease? Well, as we add shells, and let's try to fit in 5 of them since we go all the way down to iodine, as our valence electrons, as the valence shell moves further and further out from shell 1, or in the case of fluorine, 2, 3, 4, and 5, the distance between the nucleus, which is where our protons are, and the valence electrons gets greater and greater. So even though the effective nuclear charge is constant, the distance that that attraction is exerted across gets larger. So electronegativity is not only driven by effective nuclear charge, but it's also controlled by the distance over which that charge is exerted. It's a little bit like gravity. Gravity is not just about the masses of the two objects, it's about how far they are apart. And electronegativity is very much the same. So when we talk about effective nuclear charge, it does affect electronegativity in a most pronounced way as we go horizontally across the periodic table. When we look at vertical trends in the periodic table, the electronegativity is not driven so much by changes in effective nuclear charge, but the distance over which the attraction is felt by the electrons to the protons.